Hey guys, this is Flick Commentary Breakdown. I feel like Ma Baoguo and the Russian Master are kind of related somehow. This was a Taiwanese program that aired about 2 weeks ago, and it features her favorite Wing Chun fighter Chi La La. In addition, there's a lot of other great Taiwanese martial artists interviewed. So they start out, of course, using the Ma Baoguo event as a temple event to start this conversation about Chinese martial arts, where it's at, where it went wrong, etc. So let's watch this, let's translate it, and let's analyze it.
I think most of the people in the martial arts world think that Ma Baoguo is not a martial arts incident.
It's very interesting how people reacted to the Ma Baoguo. I don't know if you can call it a scandal, but whatever. Before, when people like Layla got knocked out and stuff like that, I think there were more defenders of traditional Chinese martial arts, but it seems like every time a new traditional martial artist, fraud or whatever, gets knocked out, more and more people start making fun of traditional martial arts, so the tide of public perception is turning. I mean, I think the majority of people in China already knew Chinese martial arts was mostly a joke, but the vocal criticism has been turning, and more people are just like blatantly making fun of Chinese martial arts now. And I think that's what I started seeing while I was looking at Chinese reactions to Ma Baoguo getting knocked out, was that most people were making fun of Chinese martial arts. Chinese people. Most people were vocally making fun of these traditional masters. So it was a good time. It really was a good time for this Taiwanese television program to explore this issue.
这种传统武术跟现代搏击之间的冲突，有时候是在某种层面有点商业操作。但是真的确实有一群传统武术的人会一直打着自己是可以格斗、自己实战的名号出来。
There were a lot of interviews that I'm skipping over for the sake of fair use. You guys can watch them on their original channel. But I wanted to feature this guy because this guy's a referee. He's a referee at some of the best events. You see him wearing a one championship. Love what he says. In fact, I think Andy Pai would agree with him. Andy Pai, the guy who brought BJJ to China. There's a lot of this kind of like, watch this master get beat up, or watch traditional martial arts challenge MMA. A lot of this is circus freak show fight type of money making. But on the other hand, there are certain people who legitimately believe their own BS, they believe their own lies. But those are definitely in the minority. So it's very important to express that, because I think just because it's fun to feature all of that, and there are a lot of them, but I think it's fewer than we think. If I were to put a number figure on how many bullshito masters I think there are, I'm going to say there are probably about 10,000 all over the world. I think if you put them all in a room, there's going to be 10,000 of them. Maybe it's more than that. If you count the cult around them, maybe it's more than 10,000. What do you guys think? How many bullshito masters are there in this world?
在练习的时候呢，大部分是以本身自己所学的 拳法去，你除了要去参透、去理解，老祖宗留下来的东西之外，那好，这些东西你练上身了，可是你今天实际上遇到敌人，或者是今天你在路上遇到真正的困难的时候，对方会对你做出什么事，你根本就不知道。
That is our man, Chi La La, our favorite Wing Chun fighter. And he says good things. First of all, you gotta interpret all the stuff that's being passed down. Some of it's probably mistranslated. Some of it's probably mistaught. And then on top of that, there's the uncertainty of combat. You could understand everything your ancestors or your sect or whatever your clan is teaching, but then the X factor is when there's an actual fight. Very good analysis, man. That's why we love Chi La La. He really thinks things through.
他们会有很大量的就是对练的一个系统。对，那很多的传统武术他面临问题是，他们我不知道几层啊，我据我所知，可能90%他们是不做实战的对练。 对，就是所谓的可能传统来说叫散手的对练，对，那既然不对练，不对练的情况，他根本没办法印证他所使用这个技术究竟在 real time 的情况下是不是有没有办法发挥？训练假设比如说练传统武术练两年，跟练现代搏击练两年，我相信只要身体条件不要差太多，应该几率接近零。
And that gets to the bottom of it. That's basically what it is, man. If you don't have sparring, you don't test your techniques, no conditioning, then what do you expect's gonna happen? This guy just gets to the bottom. You can cut away all the BS, all the arguing. That's what it is. You test what you practice, anything, you know. You could be studying chess. You could know all the theories of chess, but unless you play another player, how are you going to get good at chess? How are you going to know that all the theories, all the strategies are good? You could go to business school, but until you start a business, how are you going to know that you know how to do business? One of the greatest takeaways from this little feature.
比方说我今天突然做了一个挣脱或者是什么样的动作的时候，其实按照我们自己所学咏春的原理，我身体就是在发挥那些结构跟一些杠杆，对，但是外人就会觉得说，哎，这个可能就是抗衰啊。一般不了解的朋友，他们就可能会觉得说，这个不是咏春拳。
Never explore this issue again after this, and it breaks my heart because this is something so important. But again, this Taiwanese program is trying to cater towards the general public, right? They're not.In with the debates that are on fight commentary breakdowns and stuff, but Sila is basically addressing a lot of criticism that say, dude, you claim to represent Wing Chun, but all you're doing is doing kickboxing, or all you're doing is doing Muay Thai. And then basically what he's saying is, well, those techniques, they exist in whatever art that's practical or combat tested. It's just, it's called something different. And then ultimately, and I think most martial artists that train for a while will know, ultimately every martial art kind of looks the same if you're gonna test it for certain things. So if you're gonna fight in the ring, every martial art starts looking like kickboxing or looking like MMA, right? If you're gonna fight on the street, every martial art starts looking something else. So I think that's what Sila is trying to say. Ultimately, in his mind, Sila is saying,I learned all of this from my traditional Chinese martial arts training. I didn't learn it from kickboxing. I didn't learn it from MMA. In fact, all of that had roots in traditional martial arts anyways, but they never really addressed that again. So maybe we need to bring Xi Lala on, have him debate some people or something like that.
咏春拳不是用来打架的。那么练功夫，所有功夫首先第一个条件你应该是打斗的健康为首要，是不是？等于你的军队保护你的国家是首要，不是去攻击人家。如果你是练功夫，目的是怎么打人，什么打人是最好的，你不要这么辛苦，你去买把刀就好了，200块西瓜刀可以把人砍死。
Even though he doesn't say much that I think is significant, I think he does represent a specific mentality.Which is, this is not a combat sport. Why are you treating it like a combat sport? If you're doing Tai Chi, or you're doing Kung Fu, you're doing whatever, why are you trying to hold it up on the same standards as Muay Thai, or whatever, Judo? I think a lot of martial arts would say something similar like that. Oh, if you just want to kill someone, learn to shoot a gun. Or if you want to hurt someone, learn to use a knife, or something like that. See, I was kind of smack-talking them a little. As much as his argument seems to make sense, I think if you're going to make this argument,then you can't call whatever a martial art. Remember that interview with the third generation Baoguo master that I translated on my channel back in the day? That's what the Baoguo master said too. Look, if you're gonna take out complete combat effectiveness or complete functionality out of it, and it's just about the movements or the floweriness or whatever, then it's just dance. So don't call it a martial art. So if you're gonna call Wing Chun or whatever a martial art,then it better be able to actually help you fight off someone. Okay, maybe it might not be the best, but at least it's gotta be able to help you in a self-defense situation, right? That's the martial part. What does martial mean, right?
所以清朝初年有禁武令，民间是不可以学武术的。所以民间没有这样的条件之后，他往什么地方？太平的时候往修道、修身。好，然后这个是一个背景，加上小说的那个鼓吹。人民就有一些幻想的一些东西，所以慢慢的武术就中国的传统武术就不往格斗的方面去走，不往擂台走，他往这个地方走，往儒释道，往修身养性那个地方去走。那这个地方就是它是一个无底洞嘛。
That guy runs a kung fu museum or kind of like a kung fu library. Basically, he's probably the most studied, as in like literature, history, culture studied out of all the people interviewed. And I wanted to feature him because I did not know if what he's saying is true. I did not know that starting in the Qing dynasty, so the last dynasty of China, they already told commoners, so bodyguards, police officers, etc., imperial people, you can do this, but commoners, regular people, you're not allowed to practice martial arts. So then, of course, the martial art had to be like, oh, look at this, I'm just dancing. Or look at this, it's just for old people stretching in the park. That's really interesting, if that is true. Again, I don't know if that's true. And the second part's really good, too. He's talking about, guess what? On top of all of this, all these novels made Chinese martial arts look so mystical. And it's not just novels, it's movies, too. The Chinese martial artists are always beating up other martial arts and stuff like that. So it's like the training, the functionality is getting worse and worse and worse, as in the conditioning, the sparring aspects of it is getting worse and worse and worse. And then the kind of overblown mysticism is getting more and more and more. That's only going to hold up so long until a Xu Xiaodong Lei Lei type of incident.
放眼望去看到的一些市场上面看得到的一些中国传统武术，我觉得原本有的东西当然是要保留，但是你在教学或者是宣传上面，你必须不能够过于的神话跟夸大。对，我们有套路，然后我们有练功的方法，对比方说一般人讲的战马步站桩。 对，那这些东西是在练内在的东西，可是一般人不知道。那这些东西当然不能舍去。Chila
is like, there's things in traditional martial arts to keep, but in your marketing, don't even think about trying to mystify it or trying to exaggerate anything.
如果有机会，我是希望说学传统学 MMA 的人来跟一个传统武术的老师学一段时间，说。 传统武术在学什么？不一定说你以后你要学传统武术，你就来体验个半年，然后学传统武术的老师，你去试试看说 MMA 在做什么，你才知道什么叫接触，什么叫肉搏啊！不要整天存着一个幻想。我认为这样的交流是，可能它的结果会互相尊重。
I agree with that, man. And that's why I do bring on traditional martial artists on this channel too. I'm sure there are things that you can learn from traditional martial arts. Just like traditional martial artists can learn a lot from a lot of the modern sort of combat sports type of martial arts. Now, which can learn more from which? I think that is a source of debate, and depending on what the purpose you're learning martial arts and who you talk to, the opinion's probably gonna vary. But I agree, I like this type of exchange. There's two types of mentalities that I think both are misguided. One type of mentality is everything old is bad. You look at history, there's a lot of old things that kind of got lost. Good things that kind of got lost. Technology too, not just ways of thinking or whatever, but like technology. Some technologies that we still haven't been able to kind of replicate. So there's that. There's another mentality that, you know, there's all these hidden, amazing old things, you know, we just need to find them. I think that's mistaken too. You gotta find a balance. There's a reason why we're in modernity, we're in our current phase. It's because we're able to toss out a lot of the old stuff that doesn't work. So it's not good to put stuff from the old days, put stuff in the mountains from hundreds of years ago that seems to have a lineage or whatever. Put all of that up on a pedestal and not question it. So it's just about a middle ground, and in my opinion, a middle ground that probably puts a lot more favor towards the modern, but it doesn't completely throw away the traditional either.
要把事情越来越放在太阳底下这样，没有什么可以好藏的，这样是一个会让大家比较不会去误解传统武术的一个方法。
That's the perfect ending to our analysis, what Chilala said. Look, stop claiming there's all this hidden knowledge, there's all this like stuff of mystery and mysticism that is waiting to come out. Just examine it, show it, see if it works. And if it doesn't work, get rid of it. Get rid of it and spend your time doing other things. That whole kind of like myth or whatever of like the master that trained for 100 years in the mountains, who will be able to like fly and stuff like that. Does that stuff really exist? Does that stuff move the martial art forward at all? Test all this stuff, basically. That's what Xilala is saying. Test all this stuff. That's what we like about Xilala. Some of you criticize him because, again, you don't see much Wing Chun in him, but when I look at him, I see him testing stuff. He's constantly testing new stuff. Look for stuff that could work anywhere. Doesn't have to be just in traditional martial arts. Test it all. So this was Fight Commentary Breakdowns. A lot of you asked me to translate part of this. So I probably translated more than you saw because Xilala only put the segments of himself on the channel. I wanted to bring a little bit more. Of course, I think Xilala says the best stuff, but some of the other people that I featured in this say a lot of good stuff too. So if you like more of these translations, I will bring them to you. If you haven't seen some of my other translations, some of them are funny, some of them are funny and informational, some of them are informational, click on the end cards. This was Fight Commentary Breakdowns. Ready for this?